My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell. Hit the bell again so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. You saw the design brief in the intro to this video. Now let's follow the process that I used to match those criteria with the product that I designed. We're gonna start out with concept sketching. I'm sketching here with a ballpoint pen, and I'm sketching out ideas where I'm trying to meet the criteria set up in the design brief for this wireless charger. So it has to work horizontally, vertically. I come up with some initial ideas, and I don't feel that they're elegant enough. I think that I'm maybe getting close, and I'm able to use the charger in the horizontal and vertical position, but it's just not elegant. And so I ultimately come up with an idea here where I'm able to rotate and switch from different angles on the same device. It's very simple, it's very elegant, it's very sleek. It just requires some rotation by the user. So there's no extra pieces or anything to lose. It's all self-contained. So I really like this idea and I want to explore it. So the next thing I want to do is maybe make like a little proof of concept to figure out how this rotation mechanism actually works. So I'm going to use a little bit of PVC and I'm going to cut this up on my bandsaw at about 25 degrees just to get a couple pieces and see how they go together. Well, they don't go together so good that way, but this way seems to have some promise. So I'm going to glue in another little ring on the inside of this PVC and we'll see if this works. All right, this is looking pretty promising. I'll be able to use the phone in the portrait or landscape mode, and I'll be able to charge it and use the device at the same time, and I can adjust the viewing angle of my device. So this is satisfying all the requirements of the design brief. Next, I'm gonna do a little bit more sketching and kind of refine out the concept to help me visualize and understand how this thing is gonna go together. So this is a little end view. I chose a phone on top of the charger, how it could lie, and what it's gonna roughly look like in terms of scale. The next thing you wanna do is create a little orthographic drawing for yourself to help you visualize. This drawing is to scale, and it helps me see how big and what the diameter is of this tube that I have to make. So 62 millimeters with about 3 or 4 millimeter wall thickness. To do this, I'm gonna use some 20 pound modeling foam. This is urethane foam. I actually hate this stuff because it just gets everywhere, but it's ideally suited for model making. And that's one of the big things about this video, is to show another model making process, in this case, the urethane. So I grab a cylinder that's a little bit bigger than I need. I face off the end to make it flush, and I drill a little center pilot hole. Next thing, I need a little faceplate. I don't actually own a lathe, so I need to do all of this on my drill press. I build this little lathe faceplate to chuck up into my drill press, and here I'm just machining it flat. And it has a little center dot in the middle, and I can use that to align my piece of foam roughly in the right place so that I can turn it on my drill press and machine out my part. I'm gonna super glue it in place with 4 strips of super glue. By the way, I also dislike super glue. It never really seems to work well for me. In this case, it does. If you have comments or suggestions about super glue, leave them down in the comments below. I would love to learn what super glues work for you, as well as what accelerant kickers work for. We're going to turn this foam cylinder into a tube at this point. I'm basically chucking up a chisel in my cross slide vise, and I am plunging the part down onto the chisel to get me my tube. Make sure you're wearing a mask for this stuff. This urethane stuff is not great. You don't want to be breathing it in. All right, so we got a little 62 millimeter tube. diameter tube, and it has about a 3 or 4 millimeter wall thickness, and that's exactly what we need. We're going to take that off, and we're going to be able to use that to make the body of the charger. What we need to do now is we need to make a sleeve that goes on the inside of this tube, because we're going to be cutting this tube at an angle, and we want this tube to have some support, and we need a sleeve to slide on the inside of it, so that way when we cut it on the bandsaw, the blade is not distorting the piece and we're getting a straight and accurate cut. 25 degrees on the bandsaw, and I cut my first piece off. The next one, we've got to cut at 90 degrees to that 25 degree cut. I want to make sure my bandsaw is nice and square. I want to cut that off. And boom, we've got our two pieces. I cut one more piece off of the inside sleeve, and this is going to become my ring around which the two pieces rotate. I'm going to super glue everything together here. And we're going to get our first taste of how things work. I think it's a little bit loose, so I'm going to cut a little strip of thick paper. And I'm going to super glue this onto the inside retaining ring of the urethane foam. I got a couple of sheets that I cut here, about 2 millimeters thick. I'm going to glue that onto the top, and that's going to become the top face of my charger. All right, let's trim that off with an X-Acto. Super easy with this foam. It's very cuttable, very toolable. Ideal for model making. Just don't like it. The bottom part of the charger needs some weight, and so we're going to make a little ammo soup here with some clear resin and some BBs. Yeah. I'm going to let that cure in the tank so we don't get any bubbles. Here we're going to round off the top edge of the charger. This is going to differentiate the top from the bottom, having that little radius, a little softer area so that you can easily grip it without grip your phone without grabbing the charger. I've made a little adapter plate to hold the electronics that go on the inside of this thing, because this little mock-up has to work, of course. These are some pre-existing electronics. That's also part of the design brief, is this thing had to use some existing electronics, so I 3D print up a little holder, and here's the two pieces together. You can see the charge coil there and the PCB. This is roughly how it's going to fit on the inside, of course. I'm just laying it on the top here so that you can see. And I have those tabs that I've made, and we're going to trim those off. First, though, we need to remove the little LED from the printed circuit board, and we're going to solder that off just because it's in the way. That's going to make fitting the board inside much easier. So we're just going to trim off some of the tabs until we get this piece to fit. Use a little file, file things nice and smooth, get it to fit right. You need to cut a hole for the micro USB port, because this thing is USB powered. We're going to scribe that in and cut it out with an X-Acto. Again, just 3-4 millimeters of foam, and it's pretty easy to cut that out with an X-Acto, and you can get a really nice cut. I'm also drilling in the hole for the LED, just using a Dremel here, and this gives me a little more control than a drill bit. And I'm going to drop in a little piece of half-inch foam. This is leftover from the spray booth build. I'm just going to hot glue this in. You guys all know how I love hot glue. But in this case, it's easy, appropriate. I can cut that piece out if I need to. The bottom, where all the BBs were, we are just going to lay down a coat of polyester resin, so some polyester body filler. Next, we are going to paint the foam, or seal it, with some shellac. This builds up a little layer and makes it so we have to use a little bit less primer later on. Soldering on some wires onto that LED so we can solder that back onto the board, and we will have some flexibility. It'll make it a lot easier for inserting this part and making it functional once again. LED fits into the hole, and we we are all set. Now, we need to have some sort of a grip on the bottom of this wireless charger. So I'm using a latex glove here, and I spray some spray mount onto the bottom of that latex glove, and I'm stretching it over the bottom part, which is weighted. And then we're going to trim it off, and that's going to give you like a little bit of grip. Remember, this is a prototype. We're testing out concepts, ideas. We're trying stuff. You know, there's no rules per se. You need to be inventive. So this is what the thing looks like. I don't think it's particularly appealing in this shellac color. So we're going to throw a little coat of primer on there, some white primer. In the next video for next week, I'm going to show you how to take this model to a high gloss finish. But for right now, we're going to leave this the way it is. So this is sort of the beginning process of design development. Next would be going into CAD, making adjustments. There's certainly things that I would like to adjust and make different, but that's how the design process starts.
Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.